Hi everybody, my name's Andy Greenacre. I'm a visual artist based here in sunny Suffolk, and you join me once again in the creative corner of my little studio. Today we're going to be looking at another element of art. We're looking at line. So we've looked at six other elements of art over previous sessions. We've looked at colour, form, shape, space, texture and value, and we're finishing off this little series with line. So what is line? Well, line, quite simply, in an artistic and creative sense, is a mark made on a surface by an artist or a designer or a creative where the length is longer than the width. So it's not a dot, it's a line. And there's a brilliant artist called Paul Klee who says a line is a dot that went on a walk. And I like that idea that it's something that's carrying on for a period of time. So it's actually a record of a mark that an artist has made on a surface, and it connects two points with movement through a space. So when we look at that, we need to think about how we use marks when we're creating work. And what we're going to do today is do a few experiments, and I would like you to try them out if you're happy to have a go. And we're going to try and look at how you could improve those mark making, but also trying out different methods that you might want to try yourself in the future. You also are going to learn terminology that when you're looking at artwork that other people have made, you'll be able to understand what lines they've used, why they've used them, and what effects they've created by doing that. Okay, so our first task for today is to create a large doodle of lines and marks. So I've got a sheet of A3 paper, and I've got a nice drawing pencil. This is a 2B pencil. And what we're going to try and do is create a whole page of different marks. So they could be horizontal, vertical, diagonal lines. And I'm going to do this in one session. I'm going to record it for you as well. And the idea of this is to try out different marks and different lines and try and create a large doodle that's completely fabricated from your imagination and has no kind of figurative element to it. It's purely a page full of marks. So why don't you have a go at this as well? I'm going to do it now and film it for you, and I'll see you on the other side and we'll see what we can create. Okay, so how did you get on? I've got a full page of marks which are random and some are more uniform, but there's a whole page of mark making there. We've got swirls, we've got zigzags, we've got scribbles, we've got hatching, we've got curves, we've got free form, we've got all sorts of different lines. So hopefully you've enjoyed that. You can use different colours if you want to, and you could add more to this and there might be something that comes out of it. This starts to look like a sea creature to me. So it can create some more work from the back of this doodle that you've just created. So for our next task to do with line, we're going to use a piece of paper and a pencil to create the illusion of a 3D object on a piece of paper. We're going to do that with some basic mark making, and we're going to be revisiting some shapes from previous sessions. So a shape of a square in 3D form is a cube, and a circle in 3D form is a sphere, and a triangle in 3D form is a pyramid. We're going to try and draw these, we're going to render them, and as I say, we're using basic line and mark making to create a 3D illusion. So let's give this a try. We're going to draw a very basic circle here, which doesn't matter if you have to go around it a few times. And we've got our circle there. We're going to draw a very basic square, which we can go back to previous sessions to learn how to do these if you want to. But it's very easy to draw a square like this just by adding a few lines together on the page. So if you want to learn how to draw these, you can go back to previous sessions. I'll show you how to draw a 3D form. And then the last one we're going to do is our triangle, or in a 3D form, pyramid. And we're going to try and render these to make them look 3D. So notice I'm not being too particular about the shape at the moment, or the line. So how do we do this? So the main thing to think about is that you want to try and create shade and shadow on these, and light and dark. So I'm just going to use straight lines and hatching. And we're going to start with the easiest one, which is the cube in the middle. So the light's going to come from here, and the dark is going to be on this side here. So we're going to put straight lines on this side, going all the way over this side here. And we're going to choose which is the next lightest side. So this is going to be the lightest side over here, so the next lightest might be the top here, or it's entirely up to you whichever you want the light to come from. So I'm going to go for this one being the next lightest. So I'm going to do another lines on here. You might say, well, hang on a sec, that now disappears into the same tone as the side, and you're correct. So we go back to our first one and we add some sideways ones as well. Now this is a very basic way of hatching, and some people don't like doing this. This is called cross hatching. Okay, so now we've got a darker side, but we could also make it even darker, and we could do one at a diagonal as well. So you can see, without any real detail, we're just getting in that effect. I'm going to make this slightly darker with a vertical line and then a diagonal line as well. So there we go. We've got the rough shape. Now I still don't think this has enough density on this side, so I'm going to go back in the opposite diagonal as well. So we've actually got four lines crossing with each other to create a block on there. Now I think that looks pretty good. It's light, slightly darker, and very dark over here. And you can go over lines again and again if you need to add more and more detail to that. So on this one here, there's only two planes, and we can do exactly the same. The lightest side is going to be here because the light's coming from this side. So on this side down here, we can start to add some lines that go sideways. And we're going to need to do some uprights as well to try and get a bit more density to that tone. Okay, I'm quite pleased with that. Notice I'm just adding little bits and bobs. Now, I don't want to add anything to this side because the light's going to be quite right across, but actually it might be slightly darker, so you might just do a very faint cross hatch on there, fading out almost to nothing, and then you've got this effect that it's slightly shaded by this other object. Now the circle's the hardest one, so we're going to try that one. And use exactly the same idea, but these are all straight lines, so how would you get this to have that same effect? Now you can, if you want to, just do little tiny lines like this, which is what I'm going to do. Or you can actually curve the lines, so it's up to you. So I'm just going to add some straight lines here. So it now looks like it's got hair on one side. And then I'm going to start to add some cross lines the other way, so you've got this cross hatching effect. Okay, it's starting to look like it's got a 3D. And then you're going to have to add some more on top of this. Now you might find that it's just not dark enough. So you may have to come back over it and add some more lines to go further over the sphere. Now notice how they're different length lines. There isn't a line where the colour finishes or the tone finishes. We need it to actually kind of feather out because it is a sphere. So we're looking for that totally pale side over here and slightly underneath it's darker. And then obviously, as we come around here, it fades out to nothing. And that's how we render three shapes very easily. I'm now going to keep working on these a little bit. I'm going to add some, as I said to you, some curved ones on this, just to really emphasise the fact that it is 3D and a sphere. And you can do the same if you want to. Now there's one other thing to make these look more realistic. They're just floating at the moment. You can add a very, very faint shadow. So we need to think about the shadow, and for that I would just add potentially the one way and maybe a few the other way. And we have a nice shadow under that ball there. And with this one, the shadow is going to be very similar, fading out to nothing. And on this side, again, fading out to nothing. Now you can add as much detail as you want into here, and a few more lines if you want, make it a little bit darker next to the object, fading out to nothing. And that's how you create the effect of a shadow, just using simple mark making techniques. And again, I'll do the same on this, so this one would have even longer shadow, probably go off the page, the shadow on this one, and it'll get thinner as it goes up. Now, you don't have to use them quite as fine as this. You can actually go over them and do different lines, but building up the tone and the shadows by doing this is a very good way of learning how to shade an object. Hopefully you've enjoyed that. Give it a go and see how you get on. So we've had a go at rendering an object, and we've also had a go at making a doodle with some marks on a piece of paper. But there's some words that you need to think about, some terminology, when you're talking about line. So horizontal, vertical, diagonal, are they free-flowing lines, are they tight, are they thick or thin, are they dark or light? And most of the time lines are thought of as monochromatic, meaning one colour, but you could also use a variation of colours if you want to. Is it an actual line where you've drawn a line, or is it somewhere that's an implied line? So the edge of an object isn't always drawn with a crisp line. It might be that there isn't anything there and it fades away. And that implication that there's a line there can be just as important as actually drawing a big, dark, fat line. But you're trying to make the edge of an object appear as if it's there and make that illusion, and think about the contour of that shape. You might want to look at other artists as well to look further into how they use mark making and drawing. Tracy Emin's a great example, has some wonderful sketches. Leonardo da Vinci, arguably one of the best draftsmen and drawers ever. If you look at the close detail of some of the work on the drawings, there's absolutely amazing detail in the mark making. A lot of implied lines that give you the impression of the form of a human, for example. You can go the opposite direction and look for something that's much more abstract, and someone like Jackson Pollock, who drips and splashes paint all over large canvases in more of a performance and physical action of making art, and that might be something that you want to explore as well. So most importantly, go out there and try out these things. Now we're going to finish this session with me creating a piece of work on the wall. Now I've got my A3 piece of paper pinned to the studio wall. You could do it on a table if you'd prefer. I'm going to listen to some music and create an artwork using coloured felt tips, and I'm going to try and listen to the music and make lines that represent the movement that I hear in that musical piece. Now you can listen to the same musical piece if you wish, or you could work your favourite piece of music and create an artwork that way. Okay, so I'm going to have a go. Why don't you, and then we'll recap the session in just a short while. So let's have a little recap of what we've done in our session all about line today. One of the key elements in art, and we started off by doing a doodle scribble on a piece of paper to try and loosen up our ideas about mark making and lines and the zigzags and swirls and scribbles and all sorts. And it kind of helps get over that fear of a white sheet of paper I think we all have. Then we went on to create a 3D illusion on a piece of 2D paper by rendering some shapes and forms that we've worked with before. And doing this, we actually used cross-hatching, but you could take this further and go away from that very basic approach and start to really build up some depth and make an even stronger 3D illusion. We've finished off with something that I've been looking forward to doing over all of the sessions, and that was to react to a piece of music creatively. I did this when I was at school, and I thought, what better way to end our sessions than to have a play listening to some music. Now, you can do the same. You can come up with your own music or listen to a favourite piece and create an artwork from it as well. Okay, we come to the end of these sessions, all about the elements of art. We've looked at colour, form, line, shape, space, texture and value. Hopefully they've been useful and inspiring for you to get creative. But also, when you're looking at art, maybe you'll have an even better understanding of why and how artists and creatives have made the choices that they've made. Thanks so much for joining me in my creative corner of my studio. My name's Andy Greenacre, a visual artist based here in sunny Suffolk. Thanks very much. Bye.